Hello everyone, it's Stephen Whiteside here from theuptrend.com with a quick weekend update. We'll do our best to get you out of here in under 3 minutes. On Friday, we published over 33,000 charts. I've pulled out a handful to show you the big picture and to keep you on the right side of the major market moves. Last week at this time, we were looking at a VIX that was falling and still in a weekly downtrend. And that would have changed on Friday if we closed above $17.57. That, in fact, did not happen. The VIX moved slightly lower on the week, and that upper channel line is curving lower weekly. So we would remain bullish on the North American markets as long as the VIX did not close above $16.94 this coming Friday. Now, if you're watching the market during the week, we need to see the VIX close above 13.42 before we become bearish on the market. That number should be pretty consistent for the next few days as the channels for the VIX have started to flatten out. Now, back to weekly charts. There's the S&P 500 and the NASDAQ 100 making new highs this week. The Russell 2000 is still on a weekly buy signal but had a small pullback. Similar situation for the Zacks Microcap, but instead we had a small gain. There's the TSX, the TSX 60, both making new highs this week. And then if we stand back and look at the world market, there's the Vanguard Total World ETF, and it made a new high this week as well. So everybody seems to be fairly happy at the moment. Let's drill down a little more. The most actively traded U.S. stock this week was Advanced Micro Devices, making a new high for this move. The second most actively traded stock was the Canadian cannabis maker, Aurora Cannabis, making a new low. We've been on a sell signal for quite a while for this stock, so nobody should be surprised. Then Uber, and we don't have enough data yet to form a weekly chart. So just a quick look at a daily chart here. You can see that Uber has been trying to make a base for a few days now. Inside day on Friday, things would change on Monday with a close above $28.36. And of course, that upper channel line is going to continue to move lower daily. Looking at the Canadian market, the most actively traded stock was Aurora Cannabis on Friday, and again, making a new low. Then we had Manulife. Manulife gained slightly on the week. Very quiet trading there, inside week for Manulife. And then a new high for this move for Enbridge, which is trying to break out above the highs from earlier in the year. Moving from stocks to commodities, no change in trend for copper, a small pullback into the channel. No change in trend for gold, up $6, still trading below $1,500. We do have a change in trend for crude oil. We finally closed above the upper channel line. Crude oil has been looking very bullish for the past couple of months, or at least month and a half, where we've continually made higher lows. So that's a pretty nice trend higher. We're certainly not moving at a tremendous rate, but we are moving higher. So if you're bullish on energy, that's the way we're going. Then we had a small pullback in natural gas on the week, still trading above the upper channel line. So we're still on a buy signal. No change in trend there. Moving from commodities to bonds, no change in trend inside week for the 30-year bond. And then a quick look at currencies. We had a reversal for the US dollar, still no change in trend. A reversal for the euro, no change in trend. And there's the Canadian dollar bouncing off the lower channel line and ending the week unchanged. Okay, folks, that is all for this weekend's presentation. No major trend changes to talk about. The next time you'll hear my voice is on Monday morning, and at that time we'll take a look at the major North American ETFs. Have a great day, and we'll talk to you again soon.